G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. And I know what you're going to say. Not another German 135 scale. In winter uniform. I'm sorry guys, but I just love the winter uniforms. I mean, look at this little fella here. The German tanker in winter dress. I'm not a big fan of painting that camo, so I think I might have to change that to white. I think these are reversible trousers. I sometimes say pants. And people pull me up on it. So trousers. And, you know, I thought, given that, you know, he's in winter gear and there's so many cool tanks coming out, I thought we'll just have to have a look at this one. Number 826, 135 scale, Royal Model. Did a Royal Model figure just recently and actually thought it really liked him. Hence why I picked this one up. Let's have a look inside. Hey, I wasn't expecting that. You get a little map. Yeah, and it looks like, it's in colour. Crikey. Oh my goodness, you get two maps. God damn. Oh, I just love these uniforms. Anyway, let's put this out. Two hands, arms, hands, and a head. That's good to get a head and a little bit of his equipment. And of course, the map there, if you weren't watching. Alrighty. Let's have a look at this. Close up. Straight away, let's get to it. Really nice sculpting on this. Fair bit, a little bit of flash between the legs. And you do get some casting lines up the side of the figure there. Nothing major, but a fair bit in the way of just tidying up. As in quite a lot, but not hard to clean up, but a bit, if you know what I mean. On the other side, it's always good when this happens, isn't it? When you don't get it on this side, it's always like, you know, sometimes they might, I don't know, do they split the mold on just one side to pull the figure out? And that's why you get a nastier casting line on one side than the other, because it's weird. This side has it. But this side, beautiful. Okay, let's get into the nitty gritty. All right, let's get stuck into this. And again, Very nice. Again, love it when they do the locating parts for the parts. Quite nice. Nothing to complain about yet. Yeah, there's always a yet with me, isn't there, guys? Oh, look, I like the back of that. I like it. Nice creases down the trousers there. You can see the flash in the middle there and the casting line going up the center inside his legs. Take a quick look at the boots. I think that's a casting line on his boot there that you have to tidy up. Now, this is what makes it, you know, a great figure or a good figure. This one's a good figure because it's got too many casting lines in too many places. That's what... We're not talking about the sculpt, we're just talking about the quality of the actual resin that you're getting. But apart from that, very nice sculpt. And I like it. Really nice arms here. I think the hands or the fingers, if you like, are done very well. And they do have gloves on, of course. But the actual sculpting, especially this hand, I like. Very believable in 135 scale. And you can see the little wrinkles on the gloves, which I like as well. I like that sort of attention to detail. Now, I don't know if I'll show up for you guys, but there are a couple of little casting lines, again, on the arms. You know, that sort of... I hate saying it all the time, but, you know, sort of separates these type of figures from, you know, Alpine miniatures. Alpine miniatures, you very rarely get much cleanup. And I say that because, you know what, I want the other companies to look at Alpine Miniatures. Alpine Miniatures probably doesn't. And, you know, raise the bar, get up close to them, you know. And by doing that, you're going to have to eliminate quite a lot. Not a lot, but, you know, your casting lines are a little bit better. You see that one down here? It's like Andy Hobby Headquarters. He always says 2-2 or something like that. There you go. Passing line. Naughty. But I love the gloves. Rate the gloves. In fact, I'd really like these hands separate. I think Royal Models are actually doing sets of hands now, 135 scale. But these ones are really nice. I mean, they should chop these off and cast these ones up. Really nice hands with gloves on them. I like them. And here is the head in 135 scale. And sorry for the shaky head, if you like. Just holding this in my hands. And quite nice facial expressions. Expression. Like the hair over the ears. Quite nice. His mouth is open quite wide. And I don't know if it'll show up, but you can just see his teeth just underneath there. Just a little bit. Just behind his lips. Just the top ones. That'd be a good one to have someone eating. You could almost shove something in his mouth. It's quite deep and recessed inside there. You could easily put a... You could have him drinking something, or maybe not drinking something. Maybe his mouth is too open. I was going to say, if you put a bottle against his lips there, maybe. You might get away with that. Now, it might show up for you guys, but I find the emblem just at the top of the rim of his cap there, or just above the rim of his cap, a bit hard to work out what it is. The top one is a bit clearer, but this one here, it's a bit hard to work out what that is. Might show up better on it is from 135 scale, so don't get me wrong, but I'm just letting you know. I thought it, those skulls, I thought it might have been a skull, but it's not a skull. I just checked the box art. It's not a skull. But anyway, you know what I mean. But yeah, it's a nice head, nicely sculpted. Sometimes I always look at the necks, because sometimes in some figures, the necks are really thick. And then others, they're sort of, sometimes it looks like they've didn't worry about the neck because they're just putting it onto the body. And they just sort of, whack it in there. And sometimes the necks just look like a big plank of, solid putty that they haven't really sculpted, worried about. And sometimes you get these necks that have, the nice little, contours in them around the Adam's apple and everything like that. And this one, I'm in between. It looks very thick from there. But, once it sits into the actual part, I'm sure it'll look fine. But, I like the head. I like it. These might be very similar to the other ones from the other Royal Model figure I just did recently. But really nicely done with the buckle there. And the buckle on his holster there. I think, and I may be going a bit crazy, but it looks a little bit better. And it has a bit more holes in it than the one I looked in the other set. Maybe it's exactly the same, but it just looks better. And then the binoculars. Again, light I do like. Sometimes I was saying that some of these rims or the ends of the lenses are sometimes chipped off or broken and have air bubbles in them when you can pick up these ones. But these are really nice and neat and clean. And I don't know if it'll show up, but you can see the paper through just in the middle there. So there's very tiny flash in between there. It's not just a thick resin. So you can probably obviously slice that out reasonably easily. Just show the other side if you're wondering. Play for the locating pieces there. All in all, I'd say it's another nice figure from Royal Model. The only thing I would probably say is that I'd probably give the... it'd be tough, but I think I'd probably give the casting... We'll give it around a 7.5 out of 10, just for the casting lines that you've got to clean up. But other than that, the actual sculpting and the actual parts themselves are actually done nicely. Really like the hands, as I've said before, and quite like the head, but obviously I do like it when you can have the option of swapping heads out and stuff like that. There you go, guys. I promise I'll try and get onto another 135 scale German in my next video. I might pull out something sci-fi if you're still watching. Something a bit quirky, maybe. Let me know if you're still watching what you like looking at on my channel, whether it's sci-fi, Horizon kits, aliens, what else, Predators, or you like all the World War II stuff or the superhero stuff or whatever else you like. Let me know what you're interested in. All right, guys, as always, thanks a lot for watching. I'll catch you later.